Continental GT650 here as well. Both these bikes are identical under the skin, and the only differences come in the design and the riding position. So we're going to focus this review largely on the Interceptor, which is sure to be the much bigger seller in our market. Now, let's begin with the one thing we've known quite well for a while: fuel tank, a long and flat seat, and a smart-looking set of 18-inch spoke trims. As a result of this utter straightforwardness, the big parallel twin engine lurking within the chassis plays a large role in the design. Royal Enfield knows this well, which is why attention has been paid towards ensuring an organic and retro-inspired round theme for the shape of the engine fins, the cam covers, and of course the large cases that reside underneath. All of this is finished well, as are the large chromed exhausts. Now the engine is quite wide, which is why Royal Enfield has installed small metal protectors on either side to prevent the knees from accidentally coming in contact with hot metal. Build quality and finish all round are at very acceptable levels, but there are a few reminders that this bike is meant to be accessible to a large audience. You'll notice that in the simple switchgear and the lack of features like adjustable levers, LED lighting, and in the simple twin port dials that give you a fuel gauge and two trip meters, but miss out on a clock and a gear position indicator. But all of this will make good sense to you when we get to the expected price at the end of this review. Over at the rear of the motorcycle, some may not like the relatively narrow tyre, but the dual exhausts give the Royal Enfield Twins solid presence, and you'll want to keep that in mind while filtering through typically close-packed traffic in India. Made by Gabriel, while the braking system is by Bibre. Dual channel ABS is standard, but there's no electronic wizardry in the form of traction control. So fast.